find the domain, the range,
okay, so
increasing everything of this graph. So here's how we do this problem.
Okay, sorry, go ahead.
We're going to, first of all, the domain is the simplest thing to do because the domain is simply taking the inside because it's a square root. And what does that square root have to be?
Greater than or
equal to 0. So solve that equation.
I got it.
Plus or minus 4 is greater than or equal to x. And actually, that's a little tricky because when it's in minus 4, it's got to be basically in between. X has to be in between 4 and negative 4. Because just think about plugging in numbers there. That's what it's got to be. So including them, by the way, negative 4, comma, positive 4. There's your domain. So now your range is just going to be whatever you get when you plug those values in, whatever you get out from your equation. So that requires more of like actually graphing it. So take
it. Should I graph it on my calculator?
Yeah, take it on your calculator.
My calculator's been acting kind of weird.
So you know it's going to be between 3.
Because like, why isn't it showing up?
1, 2, 3, 4. You're going to know it's going to be between there and there. Yeah. What happens when you plug in 0? How high does it go?
What?
When you plug in 0 for x, like I'm thinking of it. Yeah, 0, 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So that's the highest it's going to get. Can't get any higher than that. How about when you plug in, I don't know. How about when you plug in square root of 3?
Yes, no.
Bad example. Square root of 9 is what I'm looking for. So how about when you plug in square root of 5?
5 minus 16 is 11.
You get 3, right? So what's the square root of 5?
9. Stop.
What's the square root of 5? It's the square root of 9. Can you see the square root here?
Yeah.
So what's the square root of 5?
I just did it because it was squared, so I just like, let it go. Oh, I don't know.
Yeah, it's going to be...
between 2 and 3.
Yeah, it's basically, it's never going to be negative. You know it's never going to be negative. Yeah. So it's going to, and you know the highest is going to be there, so it's probably going to do something like that.
Okay.
And so your range is going to be between 0, including 0, and 4, including 4.
Okay.
And really, this is called graphical analysis. If you just analyze what's happening as you plug in values here, as I plug in values and get closer and closer to 0, what are those values getting closer to? Are getting closer to 4, so it's going to just be increasing as I go that way.
Okay.
And as the numbers get bigger and closer to positive 4, the 16 minus x squared is getting smaller and smaller and smaller.
Okay, so for increasing and decreasing, do you write it in interval notation?
Yeah, you write it in interval notation. So it's increasing from negative 4 to 0. It's increasing on an open interval. So the open interval is negative 4 to 0, and it's decreasing from 0 to positive 4.
Or is it 4 up to?
Say that again?
Wait, oh yeah, it's 4, because when you put 0 in, you get 4.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, when you put 0 in, you'll get 4. And the maximum point...
Wait, do I put parentheses around this?
Yeah, and you have to be careful with this because even when we put a maximum, this is a relative maximum. It's
Can I do that in my calculator?
Well, no, you don't need it. Just look at the graph.
Oh.
What's the maximum going to be?
4.
No, it's going to be 0, 4. Actually, you're right. I think the relative max is just 4.
Wouldn't it just be like...
It's probably just 4.
Y equals 4?
It depends on how they ask it. Okay, ask for it. If they want the point, then you'd say 0, 4. If they want the value... Which I think is what they want.
On the final, I'll know that.
Yeah, you should know that. And the relative mins are going to be 0 because it's going to be down here and down here. And there's 2 mins. So that's how you graph that.